was dick pics. All right. Look at you all. You guys look great. Oh. Thank you. All right. Ugh. I wish I'd known it was going to be such a beautiful audience. I would have dressed like the Farmers Only spokesperson. It's fine. Everything's fine. I'm single. I'm giving up. This album's called Giving Up, just FYI. You're wearing a pink stocking on your bed. I like that. That says confidence. That says big dick, just so you know. That's what that says. No guy with a small dick is wearing a pink stocking on his head. You know what I mean? Are you straight? Yeah? I like you just give me a thumbs up and no words. I might date you. You don't talk and you're confident. I like that. That's what most men look for. No, I'm looking for that. I'm very single. Is anyone single here? Who's single? That was the sound people make when they jump off buildings, just so you know. That was so sad. Everyone was like, oh. That's exactly how I feel. Thank God. I'm so glad we're all together. There's nothing I hate more than when someone's really happy. Like when I go, who's single? And some bitch is like, wow! Like, fuck you. Why are you happy? Someone bought you a car? What? I hate being single. It's my fault, too. I'm not ugly. You know, I'm a bad dresser, but, you know. I'm hungry, so I'm small. I'm almost too small. You know what's weird? Is like, girls always want to lose weight, but now I'm getting too thin, because I don't have a car right now, so I'm poor. My car's a bicycle. I wrote it here from Hollywood. You're welcome. Seriously, I'm being audited by the IRS, and my car is a bicycle. Just think about how sad that is. The whole ride here, I'm like, I hope someone hits me with their car. This ends, or I can sue someone. But like, for real, it's funny because now I'm getting too thin. I have to walk and ride a bike everywhere, and now I've never been self-conscious before about being too skinny. It's the most fucked up shit. Like, I'm nervous. Like, I don't even want to have sex right now because I'm afraid that guy's gonna like hurt himself and be like, ow, 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 ow! Bony bitch. Anyway, I'm single too. I hate being single, it's my fault. Because I'm crazy, fucking crazy, and I know it. I love assholes, too. That's a problem. Not the body part. Your face lit up a little bit, pink and bamboo, just so you know. Look at his thumb, he's thumbed up me. He's like, yeah, I like girls that are an asshole. You're fascinating. What do we know about you? You're pink on your head, you're straight, you don't speak, and you love bubble. That's what I've learned about you so far. I just want a guy to leave my bubble alone. That's the truth. Like, anybody, like, for real, like, I wasn't gonna talk about this, but fuck it. I'm in the mood. I'm kinda angry, okay? I really am. Actually, I am, because guys go for the bubble. Now, you guys just take it like you own it, and I don't like that shit, okay? I don't. You have to earn it. How about that? We give you the vagina. The vagina is a gift. Remember when you guys were happy with the vagina? Do you remember that? Like 10 years ago, we give you the vagina and you were like, score! Now you're like, eh. Conquered that. I already planted my flag. Now I'd like to walk on the moon. Like, no, stay out of there. It bothers me. I think it's a health hazard if you touch it. I really do. And plus, it's like not even pretty. Mine isn't pretty, and I starve myself if you even want to look at it. How about that? I want to eat for a day if you want to see that. That's what women do. We think we might fuck you, we don't eat after like breakfast, just so you know. You guys think we're cranky. Yeah, we're fucking hungry, that's why. And then you call us crazy. Listen, I get called crazy a lot, and I am, okay? I have an over-texting problem. I admit it. I'm the girl that blows up your phone. I'll send 45, 50 texts back to back. I don't care. I see the check mark, I'm like, you read that shit, motherfucker, let's go. How are you gonna not answer? I know you read it. Technology, we see you everywhere. If you don't answer and then you post on Instagram, I'll blow your car up. I don't care. You know, that hurts our feelings when you don't answer. There's no excuse. I don't wanna hear any excuse. I was dating this guy who was always like, babe, I was at the gym. At the gym for 3 hours. You better look like Channing fucking Tatum. I will not take that, right? The problem is, I'm a little codependent, I admit it. I'm 35, I was married from 19 to 31. Thanks guys for that reaction, it's sweet. It's like my own funeral, just now, it's a lot of sorrow. It wasn't the best life choice, and we were both virgins, so I know. I know, imagine how I feel. I'm starting over. If you have children, you've got to teach your kids to fuck before they're married. You have to, okay? Not tonight, you know, right? You don't have to tell them if they're like 8, you don't have to have the talk right now, but just let them know, test it out, because we just didn't have good sex. I love my ex-husband so much, we're still friends, but virgin on virgin sex, that's playing the lottery, you know? I don't know like how your sex lives are, but for me it's like 1 in 4 or 5 guys are like adequate. So imagine those odds, you know? 2 virgins having sex, you know what that's like? It's like if you're not blind, but all your books are written in Braille. You just feel the bumps and you're like, I don't know what this means, but, you know, and we hung in there for 10 years. I never cheated on him. You know, I would have weird dreams about sleeping with like strange men in alleys, but I never did cheat. You can't help but your dream. We didn't have sex for 3 years. Can you imagine? I watched a lot of Law and Order SVU back then, so. Dating the dreams, what can I say? But now I think sex is love, you know? I get confused. But also, guys, you know what? I'm gonna stick up with you for a second. It's clearly not your fault. Because you guys call us crazy a lot, and sometimes we deserve it. Because we're emotional. But you guys, you know, you send some nice signals sometimes. But you're trying to be nice, do the right thing. Sometimes the right thing fucks us up, you know? Like here's a for instance. Let's say you're dating a girl, and you haven't slept with her 4 or 5 days, whatever. And she's cool. You're like, this girl's chill. I like her. And then you fuck her. And then you notice she starts to get a little crazy. Right? Like she gets a little clingy, maybe she's like blowing up your phone, 40, 50 texts, whatever. Right? And you guys are out with your boys and you're like, yo guys, I'm good, man. Like this shit was cool, I fucked her once. She won't stop blowing up my phone. Guess she just can't stop thinking about this sweet dick I gave her. I dicked her down. So good, she's hooked on it, you know, it's like meth, she loves it. I know you guys think your dick is what makes us crazy, or like the orgasms. That's not it. I'm gonna tell you right now. Not the dick, okay? We like it if you're good. That's not it. It's the after dick. It's the post-dick moments. I'm saying this. This isn't a joke. This is a public service announcement, okay? I don't give a fuck if you laugh. You need to leave and tell all your guy friends because this shit is going to save a life. I promise. Yours and ours, okay? If you have sex with a girl and you don't love her and you roll over afterwards and you cuddle her, and she stays over, and then she turns psycho, that shit's on you. I'm telling you right now, okay? That shit is on you. You gotta kick us out if you don't love us, okay? It hurts in the moment, but trust me, you're saving yourselves a lot of pain, okay? Because here's the problem, you guys don't know this. I can't believe how many guys come to me after shows and I'm like, I didn't know. You guys come, and you fucking pass out, right? Your brain's like, done, calm, that's it. You don't think after that, right? Women are thinkers, okay? And we are not asleep, ever. Trust me, like the first 3 months at least, we ain't sleeping. Not at your house. Hell no. We got one eye open. You know why? Because we gotta trick you into thinking we're perfect. That's why. If you wake up, there can't be drool, there can't be runny makeup, we gotta look good. So you're cuddling us for 7 hours. You know what we're doing? Planning our future. It's real shit, I'm telling you guys. We're laying there all night like, oh my God, what will I name the kids? He definitely loves me. There's no way he's fucking anyone else. He would never have wanted me to stay. We wake up in the morning and we're like, I'm engaged. Like, guys do not feel those things. I don't even know why you cuddle. I don't know, you watch The Notebook, you think you have to. You don't want to be an asshole, you want your dick on our butt. Why? I don't know. I just know you don't feel what we feel, you know, because you just wake up in the morning and you're just like, ugh, fucking arms asleep, shit, that's it. That's it. And then we're the psychos. I can't help it. I'll send you so many texts. My girlfriend's like, Kate, you gotta chill. Make him chase you. They chase me. I just sent this guy 7 pages. Now I have to send a paragraph explaining why. You guys know we send you paragraphs and you look at it and you're like, oh, fuck. That's me, I can't help it. I sleep with you once and then I'm like, like, I have to explain all the text. Like, hey, I'm sorry. I swear I'm not crazy. It's just I was married 10 years. You don't know that yet, but you're going to find out. And I'm a little insecure. I don't have a median. I'm used to feedback. And you're reading these and not answering, which is hurting me inside, especially since you held me. You know, you cuddled me, which felt like a thing. I thought we were together, although I did see a hair tie on your bathroom counter, which indicates you might sleep with other women. So you really should have kicked me out. You know, that's on you. It would have hurt in the moment. It's like putting down the dog. It's better to live with an animal in the long run. So anyway, I would love to hang again if you still like me. I'm very chill. So let me know. So nice of you. Usually people just block my number. So that's a good, which by the way, I know how to get around the blog. Like, you can get around anyone. I love you shaking your head yes. Like, you've gotten around so many blogs too. I can tell. Don't worry, we won't tell the guy you're with. Yeah, keep that on the down low. But there's an app to get around the block. I feel weird saying it on stage because I'm not sure if it's legal. But it's called Burner if you need it. So you can text my 45 phone numbers on one phone for free. You know about it, Burner? You've used it? Yeah. I've used it a lot. Only if they fake cuddle me, though. You know? Because I get hurt. I'm like ready to switch teams, man. I'm serious. You're hot. Are you into girls? Not yet, but you're open. You see what I mean? Girls are always like, baby open. Guys get excited. They're like, yeah. No, man, don't get excited. Once I go lesbian, you're out of the equation. So I'm three dicks away. I really am. I've been joking about turning lesbian for so long. I really do like guys. And then you know what happened? I went to Canada. Not that Canada turns people gay or anything. I just broken up with someone. This wasn't long ago. I went to Canada, and a girl asked me to go home with her. She's really cute. She looks sweet. She kind of looked like you, actually. Asian girl. She had glasses, though. She's really innocent looking. And you know what I thought? I just thought, this looks like a girl who will text me back. That's all I really want, you know? And then I started playing through what would happen. I was like, man, if I go home with her though, you know, I gotta like do stuff. I don't know how, you know? I've never gone downtown on a lady. Seems complicated just for the guys I've been with. I don't know. Right? It seems like a vagina is like a 5,000 piece jigsaw puzzle to me. Like, it takes a lot of guys months to put together, but. Anyway, I checked it out. I just couldn't do it. I was like, I'm sorry, I'm not a lesbian friend, you know? Anyway. I went back to my hotel room, though, and I started texting my girlfriends, and that's when I realized every girl is, like, open to it. It was all my girlfriends. I was like, I'm so depressed about Tom. I just turned gay. They're all like, I'm there. This is why I just think women have it harder than guys a little bit when it comes to love. And guys get mad at you for saying this, because I know guys are like, well, you can get fucked anytime. Yeah. But when you get like heartbroken and depressed, then we turn lesbian. You guys are doing that shit. There's not one guy in this room who's ever been so depressed about a girl that you went out to a bar and you looked across the room at another dude like, man. I'm not really gay, but. Fuck, these bitches are running me all over. Maybe I'll just tickle that guy's balls and see where the night goes. Ever! Right? Not even going back to your hotel room, like, texting your boys, like, yo, I almost blew the bartender tonight. It was nice. You know, and now, like, I'm in therapy. That's how fucked up I am. I'm in therapy. I'm paying a therapist. You know the therapist's advice? Stop dating. Learn to love yourself. Like, bitch, I'm in heat. I'm 30. Love myself? Are you kidding me? I love myself like 8 times a day already. I don't even get out of bed in the morning without that. I bought myself a vibrator for Christmas. I never had a vibrator before. I hope you all have one. I'm really serious because I never had one. And let me tell you something. Better than Xanax. And $60, go online, get a magic wand. Treat yourself. It's made by Hitachi. If you don't know Hitachi, they make bulldozers, forklifts, one vibrator, that's it. Like, think about that. The thing is rated in horsepower, guys. I'm not even joking, it's 1.3 horsepower. It's like fucking a Ford Focus. It's insane. In fact, to get you off, if that's serious. And then I got tired of leaning against the wall to use mine, so now I have an orange extension cord running across my apartment. I don't even care. People come over, I live in the studio, I just step over that. Don't follow the cord, it's fine. The lights flicker when you use it. It is loud though, that's the only bad thing. You gotta time it around like someone's bee whacking outside. Your neighbors leave notes. My neighbor left me a note. He's like, please stop vacuuming at 4 a.m. So, get a magic wand. It's amazing. $60 on Amazon. Actually, Hitachi, this is just an update. They emailed me because they follow me on Twitter. They like that I promote their stuff, so they emailed me and they said, hey, Kate, good news. We make a cordless version now. So, get out of the Stone Ages. Upgrade. They sent me one in the mail, cordless, so you can get that. I still like the one with the cord, you know, I like to choke myself, but whatever your other part. All right, that's enough. I love you guys. We're great. Enjoy Jeremy! We're gonna love Jeremy! Bye, guys!
What's up, Kate, guys?